Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creative Process. Today we'll be working on another graphic design concept. We'll be creating this lateral text effect which is editable and can be customized in different forms. For this tutorial, we are mainly looking for a number of easy ways to develop this design. We'll be using Illustrator to create out the elements and Photoshop to give color variations. There are three ways to develop this design. The first way is using extrude and bevel option and then applying symbol to the visible surfaces. The second way is by applying pattern from swatches and then applying 3D extrude and bevel option. The third way is using the rectangular shapes. Create the shape which you want for the design and then add pattern and apply 3D extrude and bevel option. So let's begin with the designing process. First, we're gonna be creating this parallel pattern. So select the rectangle tool and draw out a horizontal strip. Apply magenta as a fill color using this color code. After that, with the alt pressed, click and drag it down to create under duplicate. Apply white color to this shape. Now select both the shapes and click and drag it down to create a duplicate. Then use the shortcut command or control D to create multiple number of duplicates. Once you have got the pattern, we'll convert it into symbol and a color swatch. Select all the shapes, then open the symbol panel. Here, drag and drop it to the empty space. Give it a name and then click OK. For the swatch, open the swatch panel and do the same steps. This will add a new pattern swatch in the collection. Now we can delete out the shapes. Next, we'll be creating the text effect. So for the first way, type our text using the text tool. Let's give future bold font to give a bold look. Also change the color to some bright color. Now go to effect, 3D, extrude bevel option. Check the preview option, change the surface from plastic shading to no shading. Now go to map art. Here for the font surface, use a new symbol which we have created. This will apply it to our text. Click on scale to make it fit to the surface. You can also rotate the symbol if you want to apply it vertically. Also, edge the sides to avoid any empty spaces. Next, click on the small triangular icon to select the next surface. For this curved surface also, we'll apply the same symbol. Scale it to fit and expand it from both top and bottom sides. Lastly, choose the inner curve surface and apply the same symbol. Follow the same steps to increase their thickness. Once you are satisfied with the composition, click OK. Lastly, edit the perspective cube to give a nice perspective depth. Next, let's create the same concept using the second technique. So type out a text, scale up the size, then open the swatch panel and apply the new pattern swatch. This will apply the parallel pattern to the text. Now to adjust the number of parallel lines in the design, go to effect, distort and transform and open transform option panel. Here, first check the preview option to see the changes and uncheck the transform object option to avoid object transformation. Now adjust the vertical scale slider to increase or decrease the number of parallel strips. Let's give it around 12 steps. Also make sure that you get red strips on both ends. This will be very helpful in further steps. And then click OK. Next, we'll give a perspective depth to the text. So go to Effect, 3D, Extrude and Bevel option. Under this panel, change the surface to No Shading. Set the extrude depth to around 60 points and for the XYZ value, set the x-axis to minus 33 degree, y-axis to minus 33 degree and z-axis to 20 degree. This will give us this lateral 3D text. Use text tool to type in more alphabets. And to adjust the distance between each of the alphabet, we can go to character option and increase the spacing value. Lastly, let's create the same effect using the third way. It's similar to the second technique. The only difference is that we'll be creating the shapes as per our design requirement. So select the rectangle tool and draw the rectangle, give it a solid color and switch it to stroke color. Then on the stroke panel, set the stroke alignment to inside and increase the stroke thickness to around 12 mm. After that, using the direct selection tool, drag the circular icon inward to make the corners round. Now go to Object, Path, Outline Stroke. This will convert it into Fill Object. Next, draw the rectangle on top and place it over the region which you want to subtract. After that, select both the shapes and apply minus front option under Pathfinder. This will leave us with C-shaped vector. Now we'll follow all the steps from the previous technique. So apply the pattern from the color swatches. Then under Transform Attribute panel, edit the scale vertical slider to increase the number of parallel lines on the design. After that, under 3D Extreme Bevel option, change the surface to no shading, x-axis to minus 33 degree, y-axis to minus 33 degree, and z-axis to 20 degree. And extrude depth to around 60 points. Finally, we have applied the lateral text effect to the shape. Next, to give color variation to the design, open a new Photoshop document. Apply red magenta color to the background. Now drag in all the three vector designs and scale up the size according to the document to fill up the empty space. To give purple color, add hue and saturation adjustment layer on top, check colorize, increase the saturation value to around 100 points and hue value to around 283. Type out text for a title, lateral, scale down the size, use the font TWCEMMD and change the color to white. With this text effect, you can customize. For that, just double click on the thumbnail. This will open it in Illustrator. Here, let's change the text to XU and then save the file. This will update it in Photoshop. Edit the size accordingly. Another thing you can do is to edit the pattern. For example, for the text C, we want white surface on top. For that, double click on the thumbnail to open the Illustrator file. Here, selecting the shape, open the Transform Attribute panel and adjust the vertical slider until you get a white surface on top. This way, you can customize the design in any steps of the designing process. Finally, we have completed creating a lateral text effect. We have seen three ways to develop this design. I hope you find this tutorial useful and found some useful design techniques during the process. So don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, please do like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.